Hello and welcome. In this tutorial, I'm going to graphically solve this linear programming problem in Excel. First, I'm going to click to the left of A here to select all the cells and reduce their width to make my inputs closer together. Next, I'm going to type the variables X and Y up here. Then the objective function coefficients. Then for the constraints, I can type C1 here, grab the handle, and drag down for C2 and C3. Input 4, 2, 4 for X, and then 1, 2, negative 5 for Y. Then I'm going to put the signs here, greater than for the first constraint, and less than for the other two constraints. And then input the right sides of the constraints. For visual purposes, I'm going to select the constraints, right-click, and select all borders. Next, I'm going to find points for drawing the constraint lines. For constraint 1, I'm going to create a table for the X and Y values. Highlight, right-click, and select all borders. So when y equals 0 in C1, x equals 12 divided by 4, which is 3. And when x equals 0, y just equals 12. For constraints 2 and 3, I'm just going to copy constraint 1 points here and paste for 2 and 3. And then clean it up a little. So for constraint 2, when y equals 0, x equals 9, and when x equals 0, y also equals 9. For constraint 3, we can write 4x equals 5y. So when y equals 0, x equals 0, and when x equals 0, y again equals 0. We already have that point, so we need another point. So we choose any point for one of the variables and then calculate the other one. For example, if we choose y equals 8, 4x equals 40, so x equals 10. Now to begin drawing the graph, I'm just going to highlight constraint 1 point, then click on Insert, then click Scatter, then select Scatter with straight lines and markers. Now I don't need the title, so I'm going to delete it, and then resize the graph to my liking. Next, I'm going to right-click anywhere on the graph and click Select Data. I'm going to click on Series 1 and click Edit. For the series name, I'll just type C1 for constraint 1. Next, I'm going to delete Series X values and replace it with 3 and 0 here. I'm going to delete Series Y values as well and replace it with 0 and 12 here, and click OK. For constraint 2, I'm going to click Add, input C2 for series name, select 9 and 0 here for X, make sure the content of series Y values is deleted, and select 0, 9. Click OK. Click Add again, and then C3 for series name, 0, 10 for X values, and then delete this one and replace it with Y values. Then click OK and click OK. Next, I'm going to label the constraints by clicking on Insert, Shapes, and then Text Box. Click and drag and type C1 for the first constraint. Now press and hold the Control button, click and drag to copy the text to the other two constraints. Next, we find the feasible region. Note that C1 is a greater than constraint, so it is satisfied here above the line. C2 is a less than constraint, so it is satisfied here below the line. C3, however, is a little tricky because of the negative sign. To determine which region actually satisfies C3, let's pick a point and test to see if it satisfies the constraint. If we choose the point 4, 0, for example, we see that 16 is not less than or equal to 0. So the constraint is not satisfied in this direction. It must be satisfied in the other direction. Judging by the direction of the arrows, we see that the feasible region is the region here. So I'm just going to control click and drag C1 here and label the region feasible region. Next, I'm going to shade the feasible region. Click Insert Shapes and then select the Freeform tool. Next, I'll click on one of the corners, move and click on the second one, and the third, and then move my cursor to the beginning point to close it up. To make the shape transparent, I'll right-click on the shape and click Format Shape. Click Fill, then increase the transparency as desired. Next, I'll label the extreme or corner points A, B, and C. I'm now ready to find the coordinates of the extreme points. At point A, the two lines that intersect here are C1 and C2, so I'll copy and paste the constraints here. I'll also set up cells for X, Y, and Z where the coordinate values will appear. I'll color the cells for X and Y yellow and use green for Z. To find the coordinates at A, select the two yellow cells. Both of them must be highlighted for this to work. Then type equals mmult, that is matrix multiply, open bracket, then minverse, open bracket, then select the coefficients, close bracket, comma, and then select the right-hand side of the constraints, and then close bracket. Don't just hit enter. What we do here is hold down the control button, and then hold down the shift button, and then press enter. And there you have it. That is the coordinate at point A. I'm just going to copy this and paste for points B and C. At point B, the two constraints are C1 and C3. So I'm just going to copy C3 and paste on C2 here. You can see that the coordinates are automatically adjusted to 2.5 and 2. We do the same for point C. The two constraints for point C are C2 and C3. We just copy them and paste them here. Next, we calculate the value of Z at each point. The objective function is to minimize 11x plus 3y. So we input 11 times the x value plus 3 times the y value. We then copy the cell and paste the formula into the green cell for points B and C. Since this is a minimization problem, the optimal solution occurs at point B, and it is x equals 2.5 and y equals 2. The corresponding minimum value of the objective function is 33.5. And that concludes this video. Thanks for watching.